Well, good morning. Welcome to St. John United Methodist Church. We're glad that you're here. We recognize that we continue to live stream and hope that you're watching us today wherever you are around the world. And if you'd let us know, we're always glad to see folks that they would communicate with us through their leaving us a message on the Facebook there, Facebook, right? So I have a few announcements to share. I do want to pass along that for the last few weeks we've been streaming, and in that we actually have a gentleman who is wanting to join the church, and his name is Rick Ward. Been talking with him several times, and he indicated last week he wanted to join the church. So on the telephone, I offered Rick the vows of the church. Will you be faithful to St. John Church and support it with your prayers, your presence, your gifts, your service, and your witness? And he gave a very affirming yes. So this is our first virtual member, and we're looking forward to it. Rick is a longtime friend of Roy Stampley, and I told him I wouldn't hold that against him. So we're glad that he's with us, and we look forward to meeting you in person, Rick. Blessings to you. Welcome. And then I also want to let you know that we recognize that our website actually is down right at the moment, so you can't print out the order of service if you haven't already, but we'll have the songs and the words available for you on the screen, so don't fret. And then I also wanted to share with you that we have a prayer walk on the website that's for people of all ages. You're welcome to look at that, and we'll also have the communion service on the website as well, and you can click on that if you'd like to have communion today in your home. And then I want to also share with you that Muriel Williamson passed away on Thursday, and there'll be a private service for her on Saturday. Again, we welcome you to this service. Blessings to you, and let us begin this service in prayer. Let us pray. Almighty God, we give you thanks for this day, the day that you've made. And we pray, oh God, that we might be able to celebrate your love. Teach us something. Show us something. Reveal to us your presence. Help us to worship you in our homes or wherever we are, that you would be glorified. For it's in the name of Christ we pray. Amen.
Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Holy Shepherd, you know your sheep by name, and lead us to safety through the valleys of death. Guide us by your voice, that we may walk in certainty and security to the joyous feast prepared in your house, where we celebrate with you forever. Amen. And so we found this scripture, and we thought it would be beautiful in the chapel all summer long at Camp Listen. The banner says, "He calls his own sheep by name, and they follow because they know his voice." And so that banner has been up and was up in the chapel all that summer, and then it has actually been in every office I've ever been in from there on out. And so it's here with us today because that is our scripture. We're learning all about following Jesus because he is calling us. And so I first want to ask you, all you kids, do you know of any animal noises that you like to make? What is your favorite animal noise? If you want to comment right there, right under in the comments there, and we will read those, and you can challenge me to making an animal noise. Until you have given us some suggestions, I've got a few of my own. So you can make a chicken noise like this.
Jody's daughter says cow.
Meow. Meow.
Is that any others?
Carol Capers says a hard one. Crow.
Crow?
Mm-hmm.
That is my crow. Thank you, Carol Capers, for giving me that opportunity. So I think that's all my best animal. Oh, here's the best one. This is a good one. And it only works if you stick your tongue out. It's like a baby sheep. You ready? Meh! Meh! I thought that was a pretty good baby sheep. You got to stick your tongue out for some reason. I don't know why that works, but it works. So, all of God's creatures make noises, and we are God's creatures. We can make noises too. But the important thing is to stop with all of the talking, all the noise that goes around us, and stop and listen to God. Because God, in our scripture, God calls those sheep, and they know their master's voice, and they go into that gate, and they're listening. And for us, in our lives, we can listen to the voice of God. So sometimes, with all those silly noises out there, we just gotta turn it off and listen to God's voice, because he's calling each and every one of you by your names, and it's up to us to follow him. Thanks, guys.
Thank you, Pastor Lindsey, and I know that I'm expecting us to go viral with that. Y'all share that with your neighbors later. I'm expecting great things. Multi-talented. We're going to share now in the response the Psalter and the Psalm, and hope that you will sing responsibly and read responsibly the Psalm 23. Shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil,
for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Presence of my enemies, thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Ourselves to God, and we offer not only our time and our talents, we also offer God our resources, what God has already given to us. But let's now take a moment to pray and prepare your lives to offer God. Let us pray. Almighty God, again we give you thanks for your great love. We thank you that you continue to give good gifts to your children. We pray, oh God, that you would help us to give with generous hearts. Teach us how to love and teach us how to live. Use what we offer here today in the work of your kingdom, for it's in the name of Christ who gave himself for us that we pray. Amen.
verses 1 through 10. Very truly, I tell you, anyone who does not enter the sheepfold by the gate, but climbs in by another way, is a thief and a bandit. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep hear his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. They will not follow a stranger, but they will run from him because they do not know the voice of strangers. Jesus used this figure of speech with them, but they did not understand what he was saying to them. So again, Jesus said to them, "Very truly, I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and bandits, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters by me will be saved, and will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly." This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
I invite you to go to God in prayer, and let me pray for you as you pray for me. Let us pray. Again, O God, we thank you for your word. And we pray, O God, that it would speak into our lives. Help us to hear what you would say to us today. And help us to be obedient to the call that you've placed upon our lives. For it's in the name of Christ we pray. Amen. We sing a little song around the church here with the children. I don't think it's in the hymnal yet. I don't want to be a goat, no. Because a goat ain't got no hope. I don't want to be a Pharisee, because a Pharisee ain't fair, you see. I don't want to be a Sadducee, because a Sadducee is sad, you see. And I don't want to be a llama mama, because a llama has trauma, mama. I just want to be a sheep from my head down to my feet. Bye. Well, it's a fun little song. Several years ago, I had a friend of mine who had some expertise in leading and teaching staffs, church staffs, to come and to do what's called the Myers-Briggs personality inventory. And you're probably familiar with that, the different quadrants. And he had broken it down into four different birds, the owl, the eagle, the dove, and the peacock. And before the meeting had started, I kind of hinted at that I was probably an eagle. He immediately said, "Jody, you're a peacock." He obviously knew something more about me than maybe I knew myself. I was obviously a peacock, he said. All of us probably in our lives have been asked, if you could be an animal, what animal would you be? Would you be a tiger? Would you be an eagle? A dolphin? Very few people have ever said, I want to be a sheep. You know, sheep have a bad reputation for whatever reason, of being kind of smelly and also not being very bright. Although I have learned that sheep have wonderful hearing, very excellent hearing, and they also have wonderful peripheral vision. Their eyes are kind of sitting on the side of their head. They can almost see directly behind them without turning their head, but just a little bit. The psalm today reminds us that the shepherd is the shepherd of the sheep, and that the Lord is our shepherd. Now, in verse 11, which was not read today, Jesus calls himself the good shepherd. But in what was read in verses 1 through 10, we hear Jesus say, "I am the gate." First century Palestine, they didn't just let the sheep just run wherever they would run. They always stayed with their shepherd during the daytime, and at night they would return to the sheep pen. And oftentimes in villages there would be a communal sheep pen. Maybe a half a dozen or even a dozen flocks would come, and they would come into this common area, and there would be a tall gate, and there would be a gate there and a gatekeeper that would provide protection during the night. And then in the early morning, each of the shepherds would come, and one shepherd would step up to the gate and begin to call his own sheep. And the sheep for that shepherd would come out and follow the shepherd. Individually, each sheep would go with the shepherd. They understood the voice of their shepherd. You know, one of the major themes in the Gospel of John is this notion or this idea of who is Jesus? What is Jesus' identity? You know, early on in the Gospel, it's kind of unfolding even to the disciples. When the disciples finally figure out who Jesus is, Jesus says, okay, don't tell anybody yet. We're not ready to tell the world about this. But here in chapter 10, Jesus is offering us a kind of a metaphor for who he is. Not only is he the shepherd, but he is the gate, the protector of the sheep. Sheep know the shepherd. There is this connection between sheep and shepherd, this symbiotic connection. And when the shepherd calls their name, they recognize his voice and they follow. You see, the sheep trust the shepherd. And then Jesus offers a contrast, a sharp contrast, by saying that the thief comes to destroy. You see, the thief comes to prey on the sheep. Jesus said, I am the gate to the sheepfold. Now, I admit, I never had sheep. I don't know too much about sheep. I've read a little bit about sheep. I know they have a tendency to stray. I know they need to be protected. I know they need to be led into pasture. But the shepherd is known by his voice. I was thinking about this the other day, and I didn't appreciate it, I guess, when I was a child, but when my father would come in from work late in the day, maybe 6 or so o'clock, he would come in, and the first thing he would say, honey, I'm home. And I always, we'd kind of smile. But as I think about that today, I'm thinking for a child, it gave me a sense of comfort, a sense of joy that my father was home. You know, I don't imagine that the thief comes into the front door and says, honey, I'm home. Just doesn't happen. The thief comes in from the back door or from the window. And with the thief, we need to be mindful. Jesus said that the sheep will know the shepherd by his voice. He didn't say that the sheep would know the shepherd by his words. He said by his voice. You see, words live on a page. Words are one thing, but the voice is something else. You see, the voice is more personal. I have two granddaughters that are about a year and a half. And because of FaceTime, I'm able to see them. And just the other day, I was talking to them, and they were saying to me, blah, 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 blah. I think about this. They don't understand words yet. They may understand a few words, but they do know the voice of their parents. We know the shepherd's voice. The voice is the knowledge of a loving parent, of encouragement. Now, I do remember later on, my father shared this with me when I was raising my own children. He would say, Jody, learn to put kindness in your voice. That's maybe a different sermon for a different day. I say this to apologize to my own children for sometimes barking at them too much, but I want to learn to put kindness in my voice. You know, I've been thinking about the church and how we or kind of process our own Christian life. In other words, there is this kind of coming together and then this going apart. There's kind of the way we come to worship, where we are protected in a safe environment, and then we go out, maybe into the pasture, to also to be nourished. And there's this give and take, the flow, the ebb and flow of our Christian walk. And I think sometimes if we, a church that is continuing to over-focus on itself, over-focus on coming together, it begins to die. And likewise, a church that is too over-focused on being outside and never coming together, there has to be both, kind of an ebb and a flow to our Christian life. And we recognize that, yes, we are safe in our environments. We're safe in the sanctuary. We're safe in our homes. But we also recognize that God goes with us into the green pastures. And it's in those green pastures that we have opportunities to be in ministry. And I think it is in the green pastures where we discover more of the abundance, the fullness of life that Jesus was talking about. I don't know if you've seen this or not on some videos. I've seen it actually with different animals. I saw it recently with a young cow, a calf. This calf had never been outside in the green pasture before. And it wasn't really an adolescent. I guess it was a calf. Never been outside the barn. And so they take this calf outside into the green field. And it's just prancing around and dancing. It's just so obvious how happy, how joyful this calf is because now he's in the green pasture. I've seen this with other animals. You can Google that, I guess, and see it with sheep and also with horses. I've seen it with horses. Something heartwarming about being in the green pasture. I don't know if you've ever seen sheep lying down in a pasture or not. I don't know if I have it or not. It is rare to see them lying down. But in my limited study of sheep, I learned that there's three conditions that have to be met in order for a sheep to lie down. First, it has to feel extremely safe. Second, it has to be well fed. And third, it has to not have insects or flies bothering it. So, is that what abundant life is? To be safe, to be fed well, and to be free from flies. Well, I think it's actually a little more than that. When the world thinks of the abundance, it thinks of wealth and possession. And there are even preachers that preach this prosperity gospel that God wants you to be rich. Well, I'm not so sure about that. God wants you to have a full life, to experience life in all of its joy and abundance. That word life is used 30 times in the Gospel of John. And the life abundant that Jesus is talking about is not about wealth. It has to do with being filled with love. It has to do with having a life that's free of sin and free of worry and free of fear and free of guilt and free of shame and envy and greed. You know, a life freed from want, as the psalm says, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want." In other words, I shall not have need of anything because the shepherd provides. The shepherd protects. And our abundance, our joy, comes in our relationship with the shepherd. Jesus said, "I came that you might have life in all of its fullness." And the abundant life that Jesus calls us to is a life of trust, a life of obedience, and a life of love. It will be here that we discover the abundant life that Jesus talked about as we embrace love as the way to live. I don't want to be a goat, because a goat ain't got no hope. And I don't want to be a llama because a llama has trauma. I just want to be a sheep. From my head down to my feet. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Oh God, again we give you thanks for being with us in life. Help us to remember that you are a loving God, that you are our guide and our protector. You provide for us, you care for us, as a shepherd cares for the sheep. Help us to put our trust more fully in you. Bless all those today who are dealing with disease. Bless those who are tired and are weary. Feed those who are hungry. And give us strength to persevere during these unusual times. Save us from the time of trial. Keep alive in us the knowledge of your love and your living presence. Engage us so to live so that we live with great excitement, great expectation, with hope and faith and abounding love, that we might experience the abundant life that you offer us. For it's in the name of Christ we pray. Amen. Worshiping with us, I invite you to click on the YouTube channel there. We have a communion service, and you can participate with that. There will be some instructions for you to continue. You can do that later in the week if you'd like to as well. Now today, receive this benediction. May the love and peace of Jesus Christ live with you today and forevermore. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. Go in peace and know that Christ goes with you. Amen.